Hello children, I am Nisha here from Mangala Vidya Mandira. So children, in this video we are going to learn unit number 3 and the name of the poem is My Shadow. So it is written by Robert Louis Stevenson. And children, you know about Robert Louis Stevenson, like he is a poet who is born in Scotland and he is very famous for his poem, and secondly he is very well known to write poem for children. So children, let's start with the poem. So the name of the poem is My Shadow. Do you know, whenever there is a light, someone follows you. Have you ever wondered who is it? So children, whenever there is a light, okay, whenever there is a light, when you are walking also, something will be coming behind you, something will be following you. So you will feel someone is following me. Actually, it is what children? It is a shadow. Shadow means a dark area or shape produced by a body between rays of light and the surface. Okay, so that is the meaning of shadow. So shall we start with the poem, children? The very first stanza, I have a little shadow that goes in and out with me, and what can be the use of him is more than I can see. So in this first stanza, the poet is saying that he has a little reflection of him, which is the shadow that follow him wherever he goes. And the poet is not able to understand the use of shadow except that shadow follows him everywhere. Second stanza, he is very, very like me from the heels up to the head, and I see him jumps before me when I jump into my bed. Now in this stanza, the poet is saying that reflection is totally like poet, from head to toe means from top to bottom, and whenever he goes to sleep, his reflection will jump or hops into the bed before him. Like before he goes to the sleep, his reflection will jump into the bed. Can you see in the picture also, the children? The poet's reflection is there on the bed. Third stanza. The funniest thing about him is the way he likes to grow. Not at all like proper children, which is always very slow. Here the poet is telling like he finds it very interesting, his mind is very funny or strange, that the way shadow increases in size. The shadow goes immediately wherever the children takes times to grow, means the shadow will increase in his size. But according to the poet, the children will not grow according to the, means the children will not grow to the size, okay, it will not increase the size of the children, the height will not increase, but the shadow's height will increase, okay, the, because of the reflection. Next stanza, for he sometimes shoots up taller like an Indian rubber ball, and he sometimes gets so little that there is none at all, and there is none at all. So in this stanza, the poet is telling, he is comparing the shadow with Indian rubber ball, because the rubber ball bounces up and down. Similarly, shadow also grows big and small. Also sometimes what happens, children, like it becomes very tiny, very small and not seen anywhere. You feel nothing is there, okay. Next stanza, for sometimes one morning very early before sun I was up, I rose and found the shining dew. Dew means children are drops of water on every buttercup. Buttercup means a yellow flower. One morning the poet woke up before everyone, even before the sun, and what he saw a drop of water on the yellow flower. So children, you must have seen drops of water in a flower early in the morning. If not seen, you just get up early someday and walk and see. Okay, in and around you can see a few drops of water, either it may be on the leaf or it may be on the flower. Last stanza, but my lazy little shadow, like an errant sleepy head. Sleepy head means children, a person who feels sleepy. Errant means what children? A bad, okay, had stayed at home behind me and was fast asleep in bed. So what the poet is telling in this, like in the morning his shadow becomes lazy, okay, it becomes bad, who wants to sleep more. The poet is saying that when in morning he was out, okay, he is going out, but what happens to the shadow? The shadow remains at home and was sleeping on the bed. So that is the poem written by Robert Louis Stevenson, okay. So children, there are few new words, let's discuss. Indian rubber ball. What is the meaning of Indian rubber ball? A ball that can bounce very high. Next one's buttercup. It is a yellow flower. Errant. Errant means bad. And errant sleepy head. Sleepy head means, as I told you, a person who likes to sleep. Next page, page number 44. Now here the question answer starts, children. So here, what do you think your shadow looks like? the first question is, what do you think your shadow looks like? I think my shadow looks like exactly like me. Definitely, children, your shadow looks like you only. No, it doesn't look like any other person. It will be looking like you only. Next question, what do you think your shadow jumps into bed before you can? The shadow is not a physical thing and it appears faster than light. It is because of that my shadow jumps into the bed before I can. Next one, what time of the day do you think it is when your shadow is the tallest? Why? So morning time only. Our shadow is the tallest. What time, children? It will be in the morning because the sun rays are slanting at the time of sunrise. Okay, because of that reason, the your shadow will look very tall. Next one, question number 4. Read the lines from the poem and answer the following. He is very, very like me from the heels up to the head. Heels means, as I told you, from top to bottom. Who does he refer to? Okay. So who does he refer, children? It refers to the shadow. Next one, who does me refer to? So in the lesson, in the poem, what does me? Me means it is about the poet. Why are he and me alike? He and me are like because they look exactly, the shadow look exactly like you. So it is almost exactly like each other. Next one, work in pairs, discuss the following. What would you do if a dog, now here is a situation, children, we need to discuss this thing. Suppose there is a situation like a dog chases you. So what you will do? Either you will run or you will walk. So it depends up to you what situation you are going to, how the situation you are going to handle it. So probably you have to walk slowly when a dog is chasing you. Next situation is you have forgotten your homework copy at home. So what you will do? We'll just apologize to your class teacher and tell, sorry ma'am, I forgot the homework. You are alone in a room and the lights go off. So what you will do? You will light a candle. Fun time. Okay, here is an activity, children. You can try this at home. Shine a torch behind your hand and see its shadow on the wall. Okay, so you just have to place a torch behind your hand and light it up and see whether the shadow on the wall, how it looks. Move the torch a little away from your hand and see the shadow on the wall. So the moment you are moving your hand, you can see the shadow of your hand. So this activity, you can try it at home. Working together, children, this activity we can omit because it's a group activity. Moving to the next main, let's write filling the blanks. So filling the blanks using one of the words given in the bracket. Okay, so given in the bracket, where is the child whose parents have come to school? So first one is whose. Second one, I saw many houses dash were quite spacious. Which house? Which were quite spacious. Mathematics, which is my favorite subject, is so interesting. So mathematics, which is my favorite subject, is so interesting. Next one, the poem that you read out is so lovely. Okay, next one, I know the street which he lives on. Next one, I like reading books that have pictures in it. Next one, the old lady when I met in your house is my neighbor. So here, children, there are three options given, which, whom. It is an interrogative pronoun, so you have to just place it out in the blanks given there. Next one, complete this description by answering the question. Okay, here, what do you think is the name of the dog? Why is she called that? What color is she? Do you think she is friendly? What does she like to eat? So here you have to answer this question and complete, means you have to just answer this question. Some descriptions are given, so based on that you have to answer these questions. Now here the next one, write a few lines on Mittu and his little dog named. So what you will do, children, like Mittu, the name of the dog is what? Mittu. So you have to just write few words you have to write about Mittu, like Mittu is very shy dog. Mittu is very shy dog and he is 10 years old, and Mittu's name is some shadow, something you have to put, and likes eating cherry and leftover bones, something you can talk about the dog. Okay, Mittu and his little dog named Shadow. So some lines you can write, few lines you can write, create your own sentence and you can write it down. Few words are given, children, which you have to read. Shoe, shadow, fish, bush, ship, sheep, dish, wash, shell, shade, and wish and brush. These are the words, children. What you have to do? You have to read it out. Okay, so now moving to the next main. So here, children, since the poem was very small, we'll continue with one lesson also. Okay. So there is one more lesson named Robin Crusoe, and Robin Crusoe discovers a footprint. Robin Crusoe discovers a footprint. So this is one more lesson. It is part B. So we'll be learning this lesson also. I will just read it out lesson, and I will be explaining you. So, my children, before starting the lesson, I just wanted to explain you what is mean by footprint. Footprint means the impression left by a foot. That is called footprint. So, children, will continue with this lesson. Page number 49. The Robinson Crusoe ship had been destroyed by the sea. He had been alone for many years and longed for company. One day he discovers a footprint on the sand. Let's find it out what he did then. So now here in this lesson, there is a person named Robinson Crusoe. What happened to his ship? His ship got destroyed. So he was alone for many years. He was alone because he was waiting for somebody for the company, but nobody was there. And one day what happened? He discovers the footprint on the sand. Let's find out whose footprint was that. Okay, that is the lesson. Shall we start with the lesson, children? One day when I was going towards my boat, I was surprised to see the footprint of a man on the sand. I stood amazed. Amazed means surprised. I listened, I looked around me, I could neither hear nor see anything. I went up higher to look down. I went up to the shore and down the shore, but it was no good. I could find no other footprint but that one. I went to it again to see if there were any more footprints and to tell if it had been my imagination, but I was not mistaken, for there was exactly the print of a foot. Toes, heel, every part of a foot. I could not imagine how it came there. Now here, children, in this first paragraph, there was a person named Robinson. Okay, Robinson Crusoe. So one day what happened? He was just going towards the boat. So can you see in the picture, picture of a boat? So he was just going towards the boat. He was surprised to see the footprint of a man. Because whenever you will walk on the sand, what will happen, children? Your impression will be left by the, which is left by the foot will be seen. So he was looking in and around, and he was thinking like, if somebody is there, if I can listen somebody's voice. So he went to the shore, he went up to the shore and he again went down to the shore, but it was nothing, like nobody he could find. Okay, then he went again to see if there is any more footprint and to tell it had been my imagination. Then he thought it is my imagination or my thought, because he's not able to find any person over there, but the footprint was there. I stayed a long time thinking, but I confused, become more and more confused. Then what happened? At last I returned home very frightened, looking behind me, and every two or three steps, mistakenly every bush and tree to be a man. So now what happened? He was keeping on searching about the footprint, but finally couldn't find anything. So suddenly got frightened and he thought, oh my God, nobody is there, let me come home. Okay, then again he came home, and he was just, what he was feeling, that every bush and tree, when he was coming back, he could see the bushes and tree. So he thought it all looks like a man. When I came to my cave, which I called my castle, I ran inside and it was being chased. I do not remember whether I used the ladder or went in by the hole in the rock, and which I called the door. I ran for cover faster than any animal could run. So the moment he got frightened, children, what he did? He started running, and he came into his castle. Okay, he came into his cave, and he just bolted inside the castle, and he thought, somebody is chasing me. Whether I use the ladder, means he was just trying to recollect how he came, whether through the ladder he came or through the hole in the rock. And I did not sleep that night. The more I thought about what I had seen, the more afraid I became. So he couldn't sleep in the night. He was just thinking about who was the person following me, from where the footprint has come. I thought it could be one of the savages of the mainland who had wandered, means children, going, moving from one place to another, out to the sea in a small boat. Savages means wild people in primitive state. Okay, well, means in the forest you can find this kind of people. So he thought there may be some wild people, okay, who will be there staying there. Maybe their footprint it will be. Luckily, I was not on shore at that time, but what he had seen, my boat. If I had seen the boat, he would have realized that someone lived on the island and would soon return with others to kill and eat him. So what he thought, if in case some wild, like savages are there, some wild people are there, and if they see them, okay, if you see this person, what they will do, they will call their friends also, other person also they will call, and they will try to kill him, okay, and they will eat him. And so I lay fearful for many days and prayed for protection. So that worry goes into his mind, and he was alone for many days, and he started praying to God for his safety, for his protection. In doing so, I was much comforted, and began going out to investigate. But even now, as I went forward, I looked behind me frequently because I was still very frightened. So what happened, he thought, let me go and investigate, like if anybody is there really or not, or his imagination, or it is his imagination. But even now he went, as I went forward, I looked behind me frequently. So he was keeping on looking behind, if somebody is following me, if somebody is trying to kill me. So that made him little frightened. However, as I went about for 2 or 3 days and saw nothing, I became little bolder. I decided to go down to the shore again and examine the footprint once more. I decided to measure it with my own footmark. So what happened? Many days he thought like that, only somebody is following me. Later on, he became very strong. Bold means he becomes strong. He thought, it's okay. Let me go down and see to the shore again and examine. Like he want to investigate whether the footprint, what he saw, it is his or not. He want to measure that footmark. And I came closer to the footprint. I realized that it could not be my footprint because I had not come to this part of the beach since a long time. Secondly, I placed my foot alongside that footprint. It seemed larger than my own. So what he did, he just kept his foot on the footprint, and he thought, no, it is little, the size of the footprint is big. So he understood, he came into the conclusion that this footprint is not mine. My fear returned. I went home again, believing that there was someone there. The island was inhabited. Inhabited means occupied. So he came home, he returned home, and he thought, okay, somebody is there, because the footprint has not matched to his foot. So somebody is there, and the island is occupied, means somebody else is living in the island. So this is the story about Robinson, who has discovered the footprint. So children, shall we start with the new words? The new words are savages. Savages means wild people in a primitive state, in a very formal state. Mainland. Mainland means large continuous extent of land, a huge land. Wandered, going from one place to another. Bolder, more confident. Okay. Inhabited means occupied, dwelt in. So here the question answer is there, children. Just have a look for the question answer. What made Robinson Crusoe think about the print on the ground was a footprint. The footprint was exactly the print of a foot with toes, heels and every part of a foot. This made Robinson Crusoe think that the footprint on the ground may be his footprint. Second question, why was Robinson afraid when he looked at the bushes and the tree? Because the moment he looked, he mistook every bush and tree is looking like a man. Next one, why did Robinson pray when he saw the footprint? When he saw the footprint, he thought, he got very scared and started praying for his protection. Next one, choose the correct answer. Robinson ran back to his home as fast as he could, because there are 3 options given, children. You need to find it out from that. So the first option is, he was afraid. That is the reason he ran back to his home. He could not sleep because he thought savages had come from the mainland. Somewhere he had a disturbance in his mind that somebody would have come from the mainland. And why was Robinson Crusoe sure that? Crusoe sure that it was not his footprint, because he had not come to this part of this beach in a long time. So he decided, no, it can't be mine. Where was Robinson Crusoe? Robinson Crusoe was alone on an island. Here also, children, see, an island we have mentioned because it starts with vowel. Next one, how would you feel if you saw unknown footprint outside your front door. Suppose you are just coming out from your door and you will see unknown footprint. So you might be thinking, you will try to find it out, whose footprint is this? You will try to investigate. Next one, if you are alone at home and suddenly someone knock at the door, what would you do? So again, it's a situation, children. Like if someone has come to your door and he's knocking and the person is knocking. So what you will do, you will try to check it out, who is that person, whether the person knows your family or not. The words in the sentence are jumbled, write them in order. One is done for you. Children, this you have to do it by yourself. This is a jumbled sentence. You have to place it into the proper order and make it a meaningful sentence. So just post it in the group after doing this exercise. Next one, filling the blanks with the correct word. It's a conjunction. So what is conjunction, children? We have already learned in parts of speech. Conjunction means it is a joining words, a word which joins two sentences. Either it can be two sentences or it can be two words. The first one, so few conjunction words are given, and, but, because, and, so. So you have to just fill that conjunction words and make a sentence. I was frightened but curious. I decided to go to the beach, so I went along the water's edge. I ran as fast as I could because I was frightened. I was very tired and confused. Now here, write a story. Okay, what you have to do? Write a story about on a strange footprint. So this story you need to try to write it by yourself. Like you can just write a story by telling, I feel very excited to see unknown footprints outside my front door. Something you can write a story and you can fill it up. Next one, use the joining words given below and join the sentence. Okay, so what you have to do, there are two columns, column A and column B. So what you have to do, you have to join the words. I can sing well. Okay, when I can sing well, but I can't dance at all. So here you are using the word but. Next one, she wore a raincoat because it was raining. We may go to Shimla or we may go to Darjeeling. He wanted a book for his birthday. So here again in column B, he wanted a football for his birthday. So what you have to do? You have to join both the words. For joining, which word you will be using, children? And. He wanted a book and football for his birthday. He missed the school bus because he was late. So he was late to school. I wrote the letter, but I forgot to post it. So this you have to do it in the textbook only, children. Now look at the footprint shown. This is a footprint of a first man on the moon. So who is the man who has went to the moon? Who is the first person who has went to the moon? His name is Neil Armstrong. Next one, let's create a pyramid. So children, here the boxes are given. So I'll just explain you one. Rest of the words you have to find it by yourself. A two-letter word begin with B. So what you have? B-E. Since there are two boxes, so you have to write B-E. So remaining words you need to find it out. Let's work in pairs. This you can omit it, children. So children, we have completed a poem, My Shadow, and a lesson. What is the name of the lesson, children? Robinson Crusoe discovers a footprint. So if there is any confusion in this lesson as well as in the poem, you can just post a message in the group. One more activity I will give you, children. For this lesson, Robinson Crusoe, you have to just take your footprint, okay, and the image you have to forward it in the group, okay, post it in the group. And for My Shadow, what you have to do, there are two activities I have given. With the help of the shadow, okay, you have to just torch a light, and with the help of the shadow you have to recite the rhyme and take a video and post it in the group. So two lessons, one poem and lesson, we have completed in this video. Moving to the grammar section. Last video we have learned simple present tense. Now in this video, what we are going to learn? Simple past tense. Although I have given a information, I have explained you the entire tenses. So now slowly, gradually, we will be going through each and everything. So simple past tense. What is simple past tense? The simple past tense or regular word is marked by the ending D or ED. An example of simple past tense verb used in sentence would be, I went to the park. So whenever jump, so what will be the past tense of jump? Jumped. Okay. Then food. So had. Okay. Then cried. Then tried. So these are the words when it ends with D. You have to just think it is a simple past tense. The exercise will be given to you in the PDF, children. The exercise, you try to do it by yourself. Till then, thank you, children. Take care of yourself.